Ramsay Street has been home to some really memorable and even controversial characters over the decades. And Neighbours wouldn't be the same without its infamous philandering physician, Dr Karl Kennedy.
I believed everything you ever said to me.
Oh, no, Susan.
Don't you touch me.
Oh, don't you touch me. Yeah, and Alan Fletcher joins us now. Alan, it's such a pleasure to speak to you. How's your cheek?
I can still feel it.
Oh, still feel it, yeah. Now, you've been on Ramsay Street for 27 years now. The majority of my life has it flown by for you.
Look, it's a blink of an eye. My daughter was born in the first year I was on Neighbours, and she's now 27. It's bizarre. It's quite bizarre. It is the blink of an eye, because when you're having a good time, you don't really notice the years pass. Except when you look in the mirror, of course, and go, oops.
We still think you're spunky Dr. Karl. You and Jackie have been, Susan, have been almost like the mum and dad of Ramsay Street for years. Your relationship's been taken a bit of a hit over the years, though, hasn't it, thanks to your wild ways, Dr. Karl?
Well, they've married each other three times now. they'll always find their way back to each other. I always think that the secret for Karl and Susan is they both realise they're very, very flawed people. And they learn to love each other's flaws. So now gorgeous Susan just looks at Karl sometimes and goes, oh, you silly old fool. and it's a divine relationship. Obviously, working with Jackie Woodburn has been the highlight of my career. She's a sensational performer, and we work the same, we think the same, we laugh at the same things. So I think that's been a big key in making sure that we lasted.
Does it feel like, in a way, that not just the show's ending, but also the marriage to your work wife is ending? I know you two played brother and sister in Cop Shop years ago. But do you feel like you're losing that relationship a little bit as well?
Yes, very much so. But, yeah, Jackie and I have sworn to each other, because we live in the same city, so it's all fine, that we will be catching up regularly, because we're going to need it. We're going to need it to support each other through kind of, you know, this change.
Yeah, most definitely. That's great to hear, yeah. Now, you've had your fair share of fights and affairs on the series. To be honest with you, we've been digging you out all morning as well. But do you get much hate mail for being a bit of a heartbreaker?
You know, the wonderful thing about Neighbours is I've never had any stick from anybody. I mean, we do remember beautiful Vivian Grey, who reported that when she played Mrs. Mangle, she was, you know, really harassed, and to the point where she felt she had to leave the show, which is really sad. But I'm very lucky to enjoy a level of notoriety that the public find endearing. So most of the time, the young blokes will sit there and go, legend! And some of the, you know, the slightly middle-aged women might tut a bit at me, but it's all in good fun.
Do you ever have people coming up to you and saying, look, I feel like my glands are a bit swollen, doctor?
All the time, and mostly young men who want to make assumptions and ask me to diagnose something down below.
Yeah. Oh, dear. Favourite storylines? I mean, so many to choose from.
Yeah. Indeed. I mean, obviously, the big affairs. Yeah. Probably in the affairs, the one I loved the most was the triangle between Izzy, Susan and Karl, because we're all great pals. Yeah. It was a bizarre relationship that Natalie Bassingthwaite made work so well, playing a kind of a villain with a heart of gold kind of thing. So I love that story, but I always return to the comedy, and my favourite episode is episode 7000. I think I might have mentioned to you before, Karl loses a $7,000 scratchy ticket, has to find it, and he has to nude up in Toadie's and finds it stuck to Toadie's backside. Still my favourite. So
Ryan told me it was his favourite as well. So what we've got on here. Now, this morning we've been sneaking around the different sets and taking pictures. I grew up obviously with the painting of the Kennedy kids. I'll be trying to stroke that one before the end of the day. Is there any memorabilia that you'll be trying to take from set?
Well, look, like everybody, I want that picture. But the only thing I need to retrieve is there is actually a photograph of myself when I was an actor in the 70s. It makes me look like I might have been working in adult films. So as soon as they say cut at the end of the day, I will run to that bookcase to get that photo back.
I wondered what happened to Dr. Karl back, you know, way back when. What you were masquerading as? You were doing some blue movies on the side or something?
Well, of course, Dr. Karl had his band, The Right Prescription. So I try to pretend that has what he thought was a great rock look.
Your musical too. After the cameras stopped rolling, what's the next stop for you after Ramsay Street?
Well, I'm pretty excited. This year I've been working, or the last 2 years I've been working on Americana country music, which is my passion, and just come back from Tamworth, actually, which had a fantastic time. So I'm off to the UK. I'm going to do a couple of gigs in London and some music festivals. And then in September, finally, after three cancellations and 3 years or whatever it is, the Dr. Karl In Conversation show will tour the UK. So pretty excited about that.
You're going to be mobbed over there.
Oh, I tell you.
It's going to be busy. And I tell you what, the outpouring of grief from the UK about the end of Neighbours has been immense. Yeah. And I feel very privileged to do this show because it means that, in a way, Neighbours isn't ending for me. You know, I'll still have this.
I don't think it ever will. I think we'll always have the memories of Neighbours and certainly yourself as well. I think it's fantastic. Yeah. And you're an absolute gent in real life as well.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you for chatting with us.
Great pleasure.
Thanks again, Alan Fletcher. We love you.
Fantastic.